Today, Israel welcomed the first F-35 stealth fighter jet into the Israeli Air Force in Fort Worth, Texas. It's not the first fighter jet that Israel has purchased from the United States, but it happens to be the first of 33 new aircrafts that Israel has recently bought from America. Joining us today in the studio is former Israeli Air Force pilot Danny Grossman to tell us about what the new jets mean for the IDF. So, hello, it's great to have you back again.
It's great to be here.
So, what are the new capabilities of this jet? Tell us about it.
Well, the F-35 Joint Strike Fighter, it will be a quantum leap for the Israeli Air Force. It is an airplane which we call a fifth generation, which means it will incorporate stealth, which means you can't see it, along with other capabilities. The fourth generation, which were stealth fighters like the F-117, was a fighter, but wasn't really a fighter because it couldn't fight its way in, fight its way out, but it wouldn't be seen. This airplane will have full capabilities of stealth and also will have versatile capabilities of both air-to-ground and air-to-air, which means not only can it protect us by keeping our skies clean, but also by doing missions close and very, very far away from home in very strategic missions.
So you kind of already answered this, but what kind of edge will having these fighter jets give to the Israeli Air Force right now?
Well, the F-35 will actually do the work. One squadron will do the work of like four different squadrons because it's an airplane which will be able to build its own battle picture. It'll be able to gather its own intelligence. It will be actually a quantum leap in cyber as well, which means it'll do all sorts of data fusion and sensor fusion, be able to get inputs from the ground, from its wingmen, and by itself build its own battle picture so that the new pilot will actually be the commander on site, even very far away from home. And this will help Israel do all of its missions and help us keep our qualitative edge for generations to come.
So legendary Israeli Air Force ace Amos Amir passed away this week, unfortunately. And, you know, the F-35, like you said, is kind of the last generation of manned fighters, right? It means there are actual pilots flying these jets. And now we see these drones that, you know, are controlled by people on the ground. Are pilots a dying species? It's ugly to say that, but is that the case right now?
Well, we may not be a dying species, but we are certainly being threatened with extinction. However, when I mentioned the F-35, the most important thing of an airplane is that you have not only a man in the loop, but a man in the cockpit. Because essentially, as far away as you go, you need someone who will be able to sort things out for you. One of the things, by the way, which I didn't touch on before, but important to mention that Israel and the United States have very strong cooperation, and the F-35 is something which will help Israel teach the world how to use the next generation fighter. We'll be the first Air Force outside of the United States to have the F-35, and just like we were the first to actually employ the F-15s in combat, Israel was the first Air Force in the world to have an air-to-air victory. So too, we also got bombed the Iraqi reactor in Osirak, and then between the F-15s and F-16s in 1982, we shot down 82 airplanes without taking a loss. So the fact that Israel will be able to help the United States learn how to use this is also extremely important for the Israel-U.S. relationship. Now, getting back to the unmanned versus manned aircraft, you always will need a person in the loop. By the way, even drones have a man in the loop. There's always someone there. However, the thing about a man is combat, if we know anything about warfare, it is unpredictable. They always say that combat is always predictable up until the first contact with the enemy, which is immediately. Now, if you take a person like Amos Amir, who was a very strong but quiet leader who helped build a Mirage squadron and commanded a Mirage squadron during the War of Attrition. During the War of Attrition in 1970, the Russians were actually manning the airplanes, flying the airplanes for the Egyptians. And the Israeli Air Force couldn't allow this to happen, so we planned, if you will, an ambush. Amos' squadron was one of the squadrons which took place in this legendary dogfight, in which we shot down 5 MiGs without a single loss. Amos also introduced high-altitude reconnaissance into that very same Mirage squadron. And then Amos was also on alert during the War of Attrition as a Mirage pilot when an Aleutian Egyptian bomber was on its way to attack Israel. Israel had scrambled Phantom fighters to try to intercept it. Amos was there in the squadron, sitting in the airplane in shorts and sandals, classic Israeli dress. When the other airplanes were chasing it, he just took off, found it, was vectored in, and was able to shoot it down before it could attack Israel. This goes to show how you always will need a man in the loop. People like Amos Amir, who with 7 kills not only was an ace, but he was also a real mensch. As his son Ronnie said to me just yesterday, he said his father would say, if you hear me talking about myself, just shut me up. He was a man who was humble and yet strong of character, and I guarantee you that Israel with the F-35 and all the F-35 pilots who are going to be, and believe me, I've met several of the pilots, they're the best of the best of the best as our maintenance crews and everyone, I guarantee you that it will help keep Israel safe for the next generation.
Right. Well, thank you so much for coming in, and we hope to have you back, Danny.
Thank you.